Okay, good day everyone. So our lesson this morning is about the chapter 5 hypothesis testing. And lesson 5.1 is about the understanding hypothesis testing. Ang lesson outcomes natin at the end of the lesson, the learners are expected to understand the idea behind hypothesis testing, define and formulate statistical hypothesis, distinguish null hypothesis from alternative hypothesis, determine whether a hypothesis test is non-directional or directional, determine whether a directional test is left-hand or right-hand tailed, and last, sketch the graph of a mathematical model for hypothesis testing. Statistics is used by researchers in conducting studies to find answers to their various types of inquiries. For instance, an educator might want to find out whether the intelligence quotient of a student has something to do with the type of course or field of study he should take in college in order to be successful professionally. A consumer wants to determine if the manufacturer's claim about the lifespan of the fluorescent lamp is manufacturer's is true. A contractor may be interested to know whether your young Filipinos prepare to live in condominium units or not. Government and religious leaders might want to decide based on parameters whether Filipinos favor or approve family planning, divorce, or same-sex marriage. These types of questions may be answered through decision-making process for evaluating claims about the population known as hypothesis testing. By definition, a hypothesis testing is a decision-making process for evaluating claims about a population based on the characteristics of a sample purported coming from the population. In short, the process of hypothesis testing involves making decisions between two opposing hypotheses. The null hypothesis, denoted by HO, is the claim about a population characteristic that is initially assumed to be true, or a statement that there is no difference between two parameters. While the alternative hypothesis, denoted by HA, is the competing claim or statement that there is difference between two parameters. Once a hypothesis has been formulated, we need a method for evaluating the sample data to determine whether the null hypothesis should be accepted, rejected, or failed to reject. The decision rule may use for this purpose is called a test procedure. Suppose two parameters of interest are denoted by mu sub 1 and mu sub 2. If there is no difference between the two values, the relationship is written in symbol as mu sub 1 minus mu sub 2 is equals to 0. So the null hypothesis would be written as HO, or the null hypothesis where mu sub 1 is equals to mu sub 2. Example, under a formulating hypothesis, if Mrs. Reyes find or if Mrs. Reyes found through readings that the teaching technique has been effective in teaching a particular topic, then she would formulate a hypothesis such as the cooperative learning approach is effective in teaching quadratic functions. It is more effective than the traditional way of teaching it. Next is applying hypothesis testing. Example number two, bottled fruit juice content. The owner of a factory that sells a particular bottled fruit juice claims that the average capacity of a bottle of their product is 250 ml. Is the claim true? To test the claim, the members of a consumer group did the following. First, get a sample of 100 such bottles. Second, calculate the capacity of each bottle. And third, compare the sample mean and the claim. The observed mean capacity or X bar of the 100 bottles is 243 ml. The sample standard deviation is 10 ml. Thus, the two hypotheses would be yung ating null hypothesis, HO. The bottled drinks contain 250 ml per bottle. So this is the claim. So meaning to say, ang ating null hypothesis, mu is equals to 250. In symbol, ito, in symbol. Next, yung alternative hypothesis naman, the bottled drinks do not contain 250 ml per bottle. So, ito ngayon yung tinatawag nating opposite. So, ang kanyang magiging symbol, HA, yung ating mu is not equal to 250. The expression may be interpreted as, if mu sub 1 is the population where the sample comes from the mu, is the population mean, yung claim. Then the null hypothesis is written as, yung ating null hypothesis ay ito ang pwedeng maging possible. Mu is equal to mu sub 1. At yung kanyang alternative, mu is not equal to mu sub 1. Okay? So sa ating scenario, kung ang ating mu sub 1 consider as the population, so yung given natin na claim, yung mu, ang null hypothesis pwedeng mag-equal at yung kanyang alternative ay not equal. When the alternative hypothesis utilized the symbol of not equal, itong symbol na to, then the test is said to be non-directional. Diba? Kasi pag sinabi nating not equal, pwedeng dalawa ang mangyari ito. Pwedeng left-hand direction at pwede rin maging right-hand direction. So, ibig sabihin, yung magiging hypothesis natin ay non-directional hypothesis. When the alternative hypothesis utilized the greater than symbol or the less than symbol, the test is said to be directional. So, ito naman yung kaibahan ng non-directional. Kung ang ating alternative hypothesis ay merong particular na word or symbol na ginamit, which is greater than or less than, ibig sabihin nun, magiging one of the direction. Pwedeng maging left-hand direction or pwedeng maging right-hand direction. So therefore, yon ay magiging tinatawag na directional hypothesis. Okay? Okay, so dun sa ating scenario, so yung symbol natin na ginamit ay not equal, it means that the consumer group is not interested in getting a sample mean greater than 250 or a sample mean less than 250. However, this not make sense in given exercises. Okay? In the problems that involve hypothesis testing, there are words like greater, efficient, improves, effective, increases, and so on that suggests a right tail direction in the formula of the alternative hypothesis. Words like decrease, less than, smaller, and the like suggests a left tail direction. So let's say ang ating magiging hypothesis ay directional. So ito yung mga word na pwede natin makita. And the like, no? Pwedeng greater, efficient, improves, effective, and increases. Kung siya ay right-hand direction. Pero kung left-hand direction naman, yung kanyang opposite naman, decrease, less than, smaller, and so on. Okay? So let's try another example. Applying hypothesis test. Organic fertilizers. A farmer believes that using organic fertilizers on his plants will yield greater income. His average income from the past was 200,000 pesos per year. State the hypothesis in symbols. O, tingnan natin itong scenario na ito. So, ang ating magiging null hypothesis or HO, ang ating mu is equal to 200,000. Ito yung ating mu. Diba? Yun yung magiging null hypothesis. Or yun yung claim. Ngayon, ano yung alternative niya? Base din doon sa ating scenario. So, ang kanya magiging alternative, mu is greater than 200,000. So, saan nakuha yun? Ayan, merong ginamit na ano. Will yield greater income. Okay. So, nagamit yon. So, kanya magiging alternative, gagamit siya ngayon ng symbol na greater than. Recall that the normal curve evolved from the probability distribution with the area under curve being 1. It has become a mathematical model in hypothesis testing. The areas are probability values that we need for decision making. In hypothesis testing, we determine the probability of obtaining the sample results if the null hypothesis is true. Thus, the calculations can be graphically represented by using the normal curve. A non-directional test is also called two-tailed test. So kung yung ating hypothesis ay inclined with non-directional test, pwede rin siyang tawaging two-tailed test. A directional test may either be left-tailed test or right-tailed test. Or yung tinatawag naman nating one-tailed test. Yan. Okay, so directional yan. Yun ang pagkakaiba ng one-tailed and two-tailed. A one-tailed test of hypothesis is a test where the alternative hypothesis specifies a one-directional difference from the parameter of interest. While the two-tailed test specifies a difference that can fail in either of the two tails of the distribution, hence, the two-tailed test is non-directional. Okay, sketch or sketches of directional and non-directional tests. One-tailed test, tinatawag natin directional. It indicates that the null hypothesis HO should be rejected when the test value is in the critical region. on one side of the mean. A one-tailed test is either right or left, depending on the direction of the inequality of alternative hypothesis, HA. Okay, so ito nakikita nyo ngayon na graph ay left-tailed. Kasi yung shaded region natin, iyon ang tinatawag na rejection or region. Rejection or critical region, itong shaded. So dahil ang shaded natin ay nasa left part ng ating curve, so kaya tinawag siya na left-tailed. So kung ito ay left-tailed, ito rin ay one-tailed test. Then ang ating non-rejection region, ito namang unshaded. Okay? Ngayon, yung critical value natin, dalawa ang pwede mangyari. It's either Z value or T value. So ang mga symbol na pwedeng makita para maraman siyang one-tailed, ayan, ang kanyang, kung ang kanyang null hypothesis mu is greater than or equal to mu sub 0, ngayon ang kanyang magiging alternative dahil ito ay left-tailed, magiging mu less than mu sub 0. At contrary na naman, contrary pagdating sa right-tailed. Pag sa right-tailed, ang shaded region ay nasa kanan. Okay? So ang non-direction or non-rejection, yun yung unshaded region. Two-tailed test, ito naman yung non-directional. It indicates that the null hypothesis HO should be rejected when the test value is in either of the two critical regions. So ito naman ang graph ng non-directional. Mapansin mo, dalawa yung ating shaded region, left and right. So pag doon nag-fall yung ating probability, so matatawag siya na reject. The null or the given mu is reject. Okay? So kapag ganyan ang graph presentation, ay tinatawag natin yan na two-tailed test. At madali lang makita. Kung ang kanyang null hypothesis, mu is equal to mu sub 0, at ang kanyang magiging alternative naman ay mu is not equal to mu sub 0.